everyone, it's your friend Thing Noodles, and welcome back to the Noodle Planet. And today we have a few things to do. We're actually going to work on the treehouse and expanding it further into a tree village. I want to put something there, and then we'll figure it out. I haven't done much except added a few leaves to make that platform a little bit bigger. But first, let's get to the Golden Noodle Award. And today, guys, it goes to, and this is the last one on this sign, it goes to NovaCat31. And the reason that NovaCat gets the Golden Noodle Award is because she's been a fan forever and ever and ever. Probably made a comment on every single one of my videos, at least one on every single video. And the reason I know that is because she would comment so much on my videos, and they were always something about the video, not spam or anything like that, but Google or YouTube started marking them as spam. So whenever I would check the comments that needed to be approved, hers were there, and I was like, oh, look, there's another comment from NovaCat. No, look, there's another comment from NovaCat. So I got to always see her comments because they were marked as spam, and then I had to unmark them. So anyway, congratulations. Now, guys, we have a huge problem here. You see, I think we need Fluffy's help. Fluffy, get over here. You're not going to hang out outside. So here's the deal, guys. As you saw at the end of the last episode, we went swimming and I brought the dogs in and I sat them down in the house and then I logged off. And then I came back and I did some work up there and I was like, you know what? Let me move the dogs into their beds for the... where is Fluffy? Come on, for the beginning of the episode, so that we can put them all in their slots and we can choose one to come with us or whatever. And well, you know, I came and then, you know, here's Kopi, and of course Naruko 2 is over here, and then we've got Ippo Kani. And the first problem was here. Actually, I looked in here and the dispenser is empty, and there should be at least a stack's worth of steak in there. So there's been some manipulation by the dogs in here. And Fluffy, you need to keep an eye on these dogs from now on. Because not only did they do that, guys. Well, you saw Kopi. And we've got Okuron here. And we've got Ippo Kani here. And then, of course, we have Ferdinand. And then we have Kopi and Ferdinand. They have cloned themselves, guys. I have no idea. I sat them down here, and all of a sudden, when I logged back in, there was an extra Kopi and an extra Ferdinand, and they stole the steak. So my theory is that I have been feeding them such good food and treating them so well that they have gained the intelligence of human life, and they've become sentient, and they've decided to clone themselves because, well, they saw what happened to the idiot bitty kitty Maximus, and they're like, well, if he's gonna bring me and drown me, I'm gonna have a copy of myself. Not really very cool. I don't know what to do about this. Should we name them Ferdinand 2 and Kopi 2? Because this is where I sat the original two. Or that one and that one. These are where the originals were. These are the two copies. And I am at a complete loss, guys. All I know is Fluffy is going to keep an eye on them and make sure that doesn't happen again. Because they can't be trusted. I'm just completely at a loss. they're exactly copied. Even the collar colors are the same. I don't know. So anyway, as your punishment for copying yourselves, you don't get to come. We're going to stay. Although, you know, I will say that Okuron and Ippo Kani did behave themselves. They didn't take part in it. So you know what? You guys are rewarded for not taking part in it. Fluffy, you keep an eye on these, please. We don't want another mishap. We only have so much food here on the Noodle Planet. We can't afford to feed that many dogs. Come on, let's go. I was really, really, really surprised. And they didn't start out as puppies or anything. They were just identical clones. So let's go. Come on. There we go. All right. So, yep. And I don't know if you guys saw that on the mushroom. I put the sea lanterns on it, and I think it looks nice. And also, if you can't quite tell, but it did help the pumpkins grow that were never growing. So that is quite useful. So let's run up here, and hopefully the doggies will follow and not get hurt by falling to their deaths. because this is pretty high up. It would, I don't know if it would kill a dog. It might, because it would kill me, I think, if I didn't have feather falling. All right, guys. Okay. Oh, sit. And get over here. All right. Good dogs. Okay. Ippo, Connie, and Okuron are going to watch me build. And poor Cope. Oh, they can actually see it from down there. All right. Well, they can watch from below. And I think, so what I wanted to do was build this out. So I think the best thing to do here is just sort of line the outside of this. And well, that's not going to work exactly like I want it. But I think, oh, that's really close to, that's okay. All right. I think that's okay. We'll see. But yeah, it is a little bit close together for my taste on that one. We'll see. We might have to do a little bit of rearranging. Yeah, so this will be the outer part, and we'll build the walls straight up. Oh, see that? That's, I don't know now. Because like I said, it was so close. I'm not sure that I want to build the walls that high up. You know, maybe I can do it like that instead of having to do that one. Yeah, maybe that'll help them not be so close together, is to take these. Oh, see, yeah, that would have killed me if I didn't have feather falling. Ah, come on. Ah, dumb. Sorry about that. I should have been holding shift. And also, you, when I was up there doing the leaves before, one of the problems was you'll grab the vines on accident, and then you go to chop something and you hit the vine and then you fall. So this might help. Distance them a little bit. Yeah, that might help. That might make it okay. Right. Okay. Yeah, you know what? I think that works out better anyway. Okay. Put this on the edge here. And then, so what I want to do is, whatever. That's good enough for now. Okay. And I'll worry about the orientation of these later, as far as the way that they're facing. Oh, you know, definitely not going to have one there. I wonder if the front of the house entrance should be here, or it should be back one, or not house, but the walls. And we'll just do wood planks for now with this, so we can just figure out what the shape of... Do I want one there? No, I don't want one there. We'll figure out what this is. Oh, you know, I thought that I'd be able to walk under these a little bit better, because I wanted to put something underneath the stairs and sort of use that area. All right, let's get a little bit more oak out here. Yeah, that'll do. Whoops, that might have been too much. Let's just get an idea of what this would be like. Obviously, we're gonna put windows later on, but let's just see how it would look the way that it is. Oh, you know what I wanted to do? Oh man, let's see if we have time for it. Okay. I wonder where those are. When we have to go to sleep, I'll see if I can manage to get it, to get what I want done as well. Because there's something that's annoying you guys, and there's also, I mean, it has to do with Naruko, the original Naruko's grave. Well, not that Naruko 2 has died or anything, but yeah, it has to do with that grave. And the dirt there, you guys want it as grass, and people don't like it as dirt. So, but I will tell you that, well, I guess since we're putting a roof on, since we're putting this up, we can put a roof, like an actual roof ceiling area, so that you guys can see, and I'll just build this up. Here we go. There. Come on. Yes. So yeah, I'll put an actual roof on this and ceiling, so that way we can hide the bottom. Because even when we put the grass blocks, the bottom is still going to be dirt, and you'll be looking up at the ceiling, and it'll be like leaves and then dirt. So that'll be a bit weird, and I don't think we want to see that. See like that? It's a bit weird. And also, you know, I think I'm going to put another thing of glass here. Like another layer of glass so that everything's even. But let's see. Oh yeah, that'll be fine. Because if we put a ceiling, right, it's still three tall. Three tall is okay. A too high ceiling is too low. So we can do that. And then we can make it so that the ceiling... Actually, You know what? Since we're going to be doing it only for aesthetic reasons, we can use slabs, and that'll make the ceiling a little bit higher, and then we can hide the dirt below, and I think it'll give it a nice effect. And it's starting to get night, so we can go and craft some of that. But, right, so, no. Stay here, okay, guys? You've got cover. I'm not going to bring you back home. Just stay there for now, and I'm just going to go sleep. Wow, this was convenient. I do need to go grab the one grass block, and I think that is down in my base below, is it? Let's go check. I might have some here. Wait. Oh, but I have silk touch, so I don't have to go down below. Because getting up is still a pain. I mean, you know, the Bounce Invader is cool, and they are doing improvements with for optimization. Let's just jump. But one of the problems is... Oh, what? Oh, wrong one. One of the problems is that... right now it doesn't work. And it because it's so inconsistent, it's a bit annoying. I'll grab these two while I'm here. And I'm wondering if you guys have any good ideas for a very, very consistent elevator type thing that doesn't use noisy pistons and stuff, because I don't like those. But something that's very consistent no matter what the timing is, and also like really cool. Because I don't want something just like, oh yeah, it works, but it's not even that cool. I want something that's really cool too. So, right. So I want to see something first. I don't want to tear up any of the dirt if I don't have to, because it's the original dirt. So let's see. We'll just do that. And I know it's sort of like sentimental weirdness, but let's put it like that, and we'll see if it spreads with the flowers on top. If not, then we'll take out the dirt blocks. And put them one by one back without the flowers on top, and then I'll put the flowers back because I don't have any flowers in my inventory, so it'll still be the original flower. So we'll just we'll keep building down here and see what happens with that. So this definitely needs a window here, and I didn't build any slabs, but I've got a crafting table in my bedroom. Gosh, I love my bedroom so much. It's so useful. It's beautiful. That might be too many. let's get like 3 dozen. Yeah, that'll work. Okay. And put those in my inventory there. All right. So yeah, I mean, this is, it's an awkwardly shaped room because of these, because of the beacons, but there's nothing I can do about it because I did. Oh no. Wait, yeah. Okay. I did, say that we would, put it right behind Naruko's grave, and I am sticking to that, guys. So that is not going to change. Don't worry about that. Now, I wonder if I should, okay. We're going to cover up all of the leaves with the slabs. I don't think I made enough. And you know what we could do is we can sort of leave this outer part with, we can make it with glass. That was... actually not what I wanted to do there. Let's put this back there. But yeah, we can put some leaves, I mean some glass here. And it'll be sort of like a skylight area. I mean, obviously not the whole thing, because as you see here, you know, there are some places that can't be. Although, you know, we could, I don't know, we could make almost the whole... Yeah, we could make it. I think we could. I have a feeling that we can make everything that isn't a part of the tree itself, that the leaves, and obviously the dirt. We can make an outer ring of glass. You can see the ceiling. I really like that idea. I don't have any glass with me. Let's see if it's... Yes. Oh, it is working. Beautiful. All right, nice. So we don't have to change it at all. And you guys get your OCD or whatever you call it corrected. So I think this is a decent window. Let's see. If we're going to be doing, we do the slab. Yeah, wait. Yeah, no, we can do a double window like this. Yep. Oh, that's better. That's far better. And then on this side, can we make it the same? Let's see. No, see, it's going to be smaller on this side, I think. No, it is the same. 3x2, right? And yep, beautiful view. Very nice. And we could also, with this, we could put stairs here. So you can step into the window. So let's give that, or should we make, oh no, I like it like this. That is amazing. Yeah, we're gonna make it like that. So you can stand in the window. And this one as well, I suppose. Yeah, that's nice. Okay, cool. Cool. Yeah. All right. Let me get some glass panes for that, and then we can get an idea of what that'll look like. And I'll see if I have any regular glass here. Let's... Yay, Tarzan! Oh, man. No, that didn't work. Okay. Got some glass panes and one piece of glass? That's really not going to help at all. Man. Well, I wonder... I'm not sure I wanted to use regular clear glass anyway, but we'll just get an idea of it. With the 13 panes of glass, we can get an idea of the windows that we stand in, which I think is cool. Wow, those look a little weird. I don't know why. Okay, but I should be using colored glass, and I don't have time to go to the Colorific hallway to check it out to see what'll work best. But and I'm going to put on this one because this is the... What do you guys think is the nicer view? This is nicer because we've got that whole unfinished doghouse roof there. So let's see how this is with glass in it. Let's see. Oh yeah. Oh, love it. Love it. And look at that. We get a view. I mean, and we get a really nice view out of that. Okay. That is pretty nice. And then here's an idea. Let's do it over here. An idea. Let's see. Well, we want it to go one block above. So it'd be like that. Yeah, that'll work. And then we'll put it there. Actually, I shouldn't have put it there. That doesn't give us a very good idea. Put it here. Like that. Yeah, that'll be nice. Yeah, oh yeah, that's good. That's good, good. Okay, so now, what I wanted to do here is, because this is sort of a dead end, right? I mean, we go up here. Oh, and that was just the worst pun ever. I'm sorry, Naruko. Oh, man. Whew, gosh. But yeah, so anyway, this goes to Naruko's grave, and, I might leave that. I kind of like it there. Because it sort of forms the angle. Yeah, okay. So it oh gosh, I don't want to use that term, but yes, it is a dead end. And what I wanted to do was sort of create a way for us to descend down to the level below. And I wonder if we could just... No, that's not going to work because you can't go there. And I also, obviously, we want to put some stuff in here. I don't really know what we could put in here. But you know what we could do? Let's try this. So, seeing as this staircase... okay, so if we can do this properly... Let me get some slabs for it, too. If we can manage to do this... it'll link both staircases together, the upper and the lower. I think that might work. Get some of those. Let's get some more stairs as well, just to make it look better. And let's get some... There, good. I don't know why I needed the crafting table for that. I really didn't. There. Open, get those. Okay, so I think if we were to use... Okay, so if we use a... slab here. No, we need the upper slab there. So let's use the upper slab here. And I know I could use a regular block for that. But it just... Well, let's see. If I put this here... I wonder... Okay, that's actually not going to work at all now that I think about it. What we need to do is have this go... This one go here. Then we need a slab and a slab. Yes. See, like that. That should work. And the reason I want to do that is you need it, since we're changing direction, you need it to be a little bit less abrupt. Because if I were to do this, it's too abrupt. And I don't think that the, that it's, jeez. I don't think it'll really let me do what I want here. So, like, yeah, you see, like, ugh. I get stuck. Actually, why do I get stuck there? I shouldn't. I should be able to go straight up. But it looks weird. You know, it just doesn't look right. Why can't I go up? That is... Oh, it's that. Okay. And obviously we need that. Well, I guess we don't need it. But I think it works better like this. And as you see, we don't hit our heads. I think we can just continue down, or we can try this and see how this works. So let's just cut a hole right here. Okay, yep. Well, obviously we can continue down because it's empty there. Let's see if we put one there. And I wonder how... Okay, let's just... let's just drop. Okay, I'll just use wood to jump up with. Yeah, okay. Geez, wow, that's a lot higher than I expected it. I don't think that we're gonna... Okay, what we'll have to do, it looks like, because I thought that these were closer together. So there are two options we have. We can bring this part up, or we can sort of curve the staircase a little bit. And I think I'm gonna try curving the staircase. So I'm gonna just use wood planks to base it off of, and we can take those out at the end when we're done. But we'll just work this staircase down and see how far out it goes. And I think it's too far there. Yeah, so okay, that's actually not terrible. And then what we can do is, it's getting dark. And I can't get back home. That's okay, you know what? I don't have any torches either. Okay, so let's just get an idea of what it could be like. Let's do that, maybe. Yeah, that'll work. Okay. And then if we were to, that's not going to do it. If we were to, let's see. So if we got that, we need to bring that down one or half of a block like so. Although it might take them both. No. Okay. There we go. So that, okay. That's not terrible. Then here. Nope. There we go. And then we have finally this one here. And then we have this last bit there. So we come up like this, and we come this way, and we get stuck with our head. So we need to take out one more block here, and then we're good. Now let's see how that is. That's a little bit more than I wanted to take out. But it's what's necessary for your head to fit. Oh, or I wonder, will this save us? Oh, man. I thought we could get away with it, but I'm... What a shame. For now we'll do that. And you can sort of hide it. So if let's just put that there and see. So I could hide it sort of by putting something there. So when you're up here, it looks like that's part of it, but then when you go under, you can see the bottom of it, but I don't know. We'll see, because that'll let us make it down, and then we're here, and yeah, that's not terrible. We'll have to brace the sides, obviously, because we don't want to fall off. This will be a wall here on the left, something like this, right? So that way you can't fall, and it looks like a staircase into here, and so here is the theory, and. I guess because we're running out of time here. I guess I'll continue this off camera a little bit and work. You know, you guys got the idea of what's going on here. Ooh, let's check the grass here. Let's check it out. Oh yeah. Okay, you guys were right. You guys were right. The green is beautiful. It is beautiful, and it's no longer a dead end. I get it, because there's a live grass now. Okay, so the idea is, you know, you come across from my from the bedroom here, this part of the main treehouse, then you come to here, and you can go up to Naruko's grave, or you can go down here, and we'll put stuff in here. I don't know what yet. Then you've got this, which is going to be something, of course, and we're going to have to put more... glass there, and then I'm gonna have two bridges. I'm gonna have one bridge from here to that, and then one bridge from over on this end to that, and then I'm gonna have a tiny bridge that sort of links them together somehow. So then we'll have like a network, a further network of the treehouse and sort of expand things further in the trees. And then, I mean, I don't know where the next tree we're going to colonize is. Let's get up here and maybe we can see. But I don't know. There's not much left. I mean, there's that one. But that's a long way away. Cool. Well, oh, that looks pretty good. That, oh, but the glass block on the outside. Woo! Well, I'll use like stairs or something to make it fit in. Either stairs or slabs or something, because that is ugly. Woo! Can I make it? No. I thought I could make it there. But yeah, if we put something like this there, it'll make it blend a little bit better, I think. Whoo, because otherwise, yuck! All right, guys, hope you enjoyed this episode on the Noodle Planet. I'll see you guys again soon. Thanks for watching, and of course, noodle on!